whatever it is that you deem to be successful, if you're doing that, you're winning. You're winning and you're a boss. That's it. Hi guys, it's Angel. Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started, take a look at the description box below. You'll find my Instagram, you'll find my Twitter. Other than that, hit the subscribe button so that you can keep up with me here on YouTube. I also started putting the link to my SoundCloud in the description box so that you guys can keep up with my podcast on SoundCloud. And I also have my two online stores. I also have the two links to my online stores in the description box as well, so take a look around and click on stuff and follow me on stuff. And I've been trying to get this video done for what seems like forever, but I've been doing other stuff, fun quarantine activities. But yeah, I've been trying to do this video for what seems like forever, but it just hasn't been, I just haven't had the time to like sit down and record it. Plus when I was telling you guys to ask me questions, y'all suck. Y'all are so bad at asking questions. Y'all are bad at asking for advice. Like, y'all are trash, but it's okay. We're here. If you didn't get to ask me a question this time, this is the first Ask Angel video I'm doing, but I want to continue to like do more, because it doesn't really necessarily just have to be a question about me. It can be a question, like, it could be a question that, you know, you just want answered, or like I said, advice, or just anything. I don't know, you can ask me anything. So again, it's not gonna be the first one. I mean, it's not gonna be the last one. So if you didn't get to ask me a question or, you know, approach me with anything this time, you can do it in the next one that I do. I have some snacks because I got some munchies. Shocker. Okay. Today, we're doing my Ask Angel video. So I asked you guys to give me 5 questions that I can answer for you guys on here on YouTube. And you guys did that, so now I'm here to answer the questions. I also wrote the questions down in my notepad, so if you see me looking down, it's because I'm referring to the questions. But anyway, my first question that I'm gonna answer, I'm gonna say the questions how the other person is asking it, you know, so that I can answer it. But whatever. I hope that makes sense. But whatever. So the first question: why are you always high? Bro, I didn't even intend to be like this high for this video. I'm a mess. I didn't even intend to be like high for this video, but I knew when I saw that question, I was like, that's the first question I'm answering, yo. That's the first question. Anyway, why am I always high? Like, what else would I be doing? Like, I don't really drink that much, like, that often anymore. Like, I'm an adult, so of course, like, I'll have like a little sip here or something, like, if I'm out. Like, if I'm out or something, I'll have a drink. But for the most part, like, I don't drink. And I just feel like marijuana is just, like, I feel like I'm speaking, like, personally, I feel like it enhances, like, my creativity. Like it heightens my senses. Like, it just keeps me, like, I feel like it just makes me produce great things, or like it makes me have like great thoughts. Like, I don't know, it just allows me to I feel like it allows me to tap into like a piece of my brain that I normally can't tap into. And I know that sounds crazy, but that's just how I feel. The movie Limitless, I always tell people, like, I think that remember he like took the pill, and when he was sober, he would be just like not noticing much around him, like everything was kind of just like normal. But then when he took the pill, it like enhanced everything, and he was seeing in like these vibrant colors and like all that other stuff. Like, that's, I feel like that's marijuana. I feel like that movie was about marijuana, because honestly, like, that's what it does for me. I feel like once I like realize that I'm high, everything is just like, wow, like this is the world. this is the world that I want to be a part of. Like, and then when I'm sober, I'm like, this shit is trash. Because at the end of the day, it's trash. Like, it's definitely trash. And I feel like, I'm not even going to go there with y'all right now. But, like, life is so deep. Like, you, like, there's so much to understand. And, like, when you really start understanding, like, life and, like, the things that go on in life. And, like, you need something. Like, you need something to get through it. That's why I try so hard not to, like, judge people. Like, whatever your vice is. Because we all have something that we need to, like, get us through. You know what I mean? Like, we all have something that we need to make, to take the edge off, to just make, you know, living day to day a little better. And so I try not to judge people. Like, whatever your vice is, you go ahead, because you need it. Like, you need something to really just, like, get you through. And I mean, for me, it's just marijuana. I mean, it's natural. Like, it's for us, you know? Like, it was put here for us. Like, I hate to sound like one of those people. I sound like a hippie, but I, like, that's just facts. Like, it was put here for us to enjoy, so I'm enjoying it. Wear this new. Second question, is my body real? Yes, that's it's crazy because that question actually came up like 3 times. I was like, I wasn't gonna answer it, but I was like, damn, like people are asking, so I'm gonna answer it. Yes, my body's real. I roll my eyes because I'm upset that my body's real. I roll my eyes because I really do want surgery. But I've been saying it for so long that I know y'all are tired of hearing it. I know the people that know me are so tired of hearing it because, like, Angel, you're never gonna get it. But, like, here's my thing. I work out, and I've been working out for, like, 10. I just turned 25, and I started working out in high school. I'm trying to think what age I was. Let's just say 10 years. I've been working out for about 10 years now. That being said, I think 100% that even though I'm not where I want to be, to me, like, body-wise, my body isn't where I want it to be necessarily. I can see, like, the great effects that working out for 10 plus years has, like, done for my body. So, like, I'm in a better shape than, you know, what I was. I remember, like, back then when I first started working out, being like, I want my body to look like this. And I can honestly say that now my body does look like that. So, like, I love that. Where was I going with this? I've been working out for 10 plus years. And even when I first started working out, the reason I started working out is because I was like, I want my body to look like this. I'm in high school, so I can't afford surgery. Like, I'm, again, still in high school, so my body is pretty much, like, not fully developed yet. But I was, like, I started developing, like, super young. I started developing super young, but I was, what, 15, 16, so I still wasn't fully developed, you know? So I got that going on. I can't afford surgery, and I'm just like, you know what? Like, let me just see what I can do, you know, to help my body be that way. So started working out in high school, and then, again, still saying, like, I want surgery. But throughout the years, I would have never guessed that. See, back when I started working out, when I was in high school, I remember that being, like, that's when strip clubs really started, like, getting traction. Like, that's when, like, because, you know, I'm trying to give y'all, like, what was that 2 Chainz song? With Nicki Minaj, I Love the Strippers, or Strippers, or something, like, whatever it was called. Bands Make Her Dance. Like, that's when strip clubs really started getting a lot of traction. Like, it was everywhere in the music. It was everywhere on TV. Like, but before that, strip clubs were hush. Like, strip clubs were never, like, it was a secret to work at a strip club. It was a secret to go to strip clubs. You know what I mean? It was super, like, hush. It was, you know what I mean? Like, so, like, around that time, that's when strip clubs really started getting popular. And then that's when you started seeing, like, all these crazy-ass bodies, like, freaking. I mean, before that, of course, we had, like, video vixens and stuff, but, like, that's when you really just started seeing everyday people having these crazy-ass bodies. And it's like, bro, like, where you get that body from? And, of course, like, me, a teenager at 15, 16, you know, that's that age where you really try to, you know, you're finding yourself and you're trying to, you know, grow yourself as an adult, and, like, damn, like, I'm gonna look like that, you know, I'm gonna look like that, like, I wanna, you know what I mean, like, whatever. But, so yeah, that's when strip clubs started getting popular. I was like, fuck it, let me just see what I can do for my body. So I started taking like some supplements that I still take to this day. I started taking like two supplements, and I started working out, started eating freaking crazy, and whatever, just started getting my body again. Plastic surgery took off like out of nowhere, and I would have never guessed that plastic surgery would have got like that popular. I mean, of course, plastic surgery was always a thing, people were getting it, but it took off like crazy. And as that was happening, again, I still wasn't able to afford, you know, the plastic surgery, but watching like everybody else get it, I'm like, damn, like, all right, I gotta figure it out. Like, I want it. Like, this is what I can't wait to get older and be able to afford it so I can get it. That's it. Then they started fucking y'all up. Then people started getting crazy looking. Like, people started just getting the surgeries just to get them, just to have them. And it started scaring me because I didn't know if I couldn't, like, I didn't know if it was the doctor's fault or if it was the person that went and got it's fault. You know what I mean? Because, like, these, like, people are going, people are going to the extreme to get what they want. You know what I mean? So people are going to people are trusting people with their bodies that they should never. That's on them. Like, if you know you can't trust that person with your body, you sitting here letting them do a whole surgery for you, it's like, that's their fault. Or, like, I didn't know if it was, you know, you're wholeheartedly going to this surgeon thinking you're gonna look like this, and you get off the table and it's like, bro, what the fuck? Like, I got scared. And for me now, it's like, I don't want to throw away 10 plus years of me working out, because even if I do get surgery, I still plan on working out. Like, that's just, I feel like I hate working out so much, but like, that's just my life now because I've been doing it for so long. I don't want to throw away 10 plus years of like hard work and, you know, like a body that I don't mind, like a body that's not perfect in my eyes, but I still don't mind it, for some trash ass looking body. Like, I don't want to do that. So like, I still keep saying it because I know once I get rich, I'll be able to afford whoever I want. I'll be able to go to whoever to get whatever, you know what I mean? So plastic surgery is still a possibility. Like, I still want it, but like, I'm not completely consumed by it anymore, because the age I was telling you about when I was in high school and I started working out, I was completely consumed by it. I was like, no, I need this. Like, I want this. And it's still there. Like, people tell me all the time, like, I don't need it. And people think that I don't, but it's like, anyone that knows, it's like, it's you. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, you can tell me 3 times that I don't need something, but if I want it, I need to, you know what I mean? But I don't know. I'm not completely like in need of it now. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I still want it, but I'm not willing to just go get it. You know what I mean? I don't know. Whatever. I hope that makes sense. Number 3. I love this question. I'm happy that I can answer this question. 3. Is everyone meant to be an entrepreneur? No. In my opinion, no. I don't think everyone's meant to be an entrepreneur, and here's why. First of all, I think that there's two types of people. There are more dominant people, and there are of course more submissive people. I think for some reason a lot of people are under the impression that submissive is bad and dominant is good. Like, submissive is not bad, but submissive may be uncomfortable for you if you're a more dominant person, just like being dominant may be a little bit uncomfortable if you're a submissive person. I think being an entrepreneur requires a very dominant person. Everything that a dominant person would be, so like goal-oriented and determined and like super stern and just like focused, like all of those things, I think a dominant person is. And I think that all of that is required in entrepreneurship. There are people out there that can't do that. There are people out there that can't lead. Like, they don't, not that they can, like, not that they can, but they don't want to lead. Like, they don't have a need to lead, and that's fine. They don't mind working on a team. They don't have to be the owner. They don't have to be the creator. They like to, you know, work under someone. They like to have direction and be the one to fulfill it. That's fine. All of that is fine. Like, I think that people, for some reason, think that everybody needs to be an entrepreneur, and like that's not the case. Like, there are people, like, because if everyone's an entrepreneur, like, who's gonna work for me? You know what I mean? Like, who's gonna work for me? Who's gonna work for this person? Like, we need dominant people and we need submissive people. Like, this like, that's just how the world is. Like, we need both of those types of people. Going off of that, there's a lot of work that has to be done as an entrepreneur. There's a lot of work that has to be done before you start seeing a profit, before people start knowing who you are, before all of that, before all of the good things, before all of like the victories, and that there's so much that has to happen before that. There's so much work and time and energy that has to go into that, and not a lot of people are willing to put that work in. Like, I always tell people, or I always say, like, because for me, I think I knew I wanted to be an entrepreneur when I was in high school. I think like 10th, 11th grade. I was like, I don't know, and I didn't really have an idea of what I wanted to do as far as what businesses I wanted to open or have, or, you know, which route I wanted to take in entrepreneurship, but I knew that I didn't want to work for people. I just have a problem with authority. I think anyone that knows me knows, like, I do what I want. Like, and it's not on purpose, it's just like, no, like, I don't like people telling me what to do. Like, one, I'm an Aries, and two, I'm just hella headstrong. Like, once I have in my mind that I want to do something, like, I want to do it. Like, and that's it. Like, I get, like, why you're saying I can't. Like, I understand, like, why you're trying to tell me no, but I don't care. Like, I want to do it anyway. Like, I've always been like that. I like doing what I want. I have never in my life been on time, ever. I think if I ever was on time, it was like twice, and that was probably like, I still was 5 minutes late. Like, those two things prohibit me from working for anyone. Like, who am I working for? I swear, every job that I've had, I've been late, bro. Like, and I'm not even saying that to, like, I dead ass cannot be on time. Like, I just have a problem with tardiness. Like, it's just my thing. And I'm not talking like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, nah, like, bro, I'm late. Like, if I had to get up at 6, I would dead ass wake up at 2 to try to start getting ready just to not be late, and I would still be late. Like, it's just in me. Like, I don't know what it is. I'm just gonna be late. That's just what it is. Like, that, and then I also just don't like people telling me what to do. Who am I gonna work for? Nobody. I'm working for myself. I'm just gonna do it my way. The fuck? Because, like, I'm never gonna find a permanent spot. Also, every job that I've had, I never stay for longer than like a year, year and a half. I don't have a job now. Like, I don't work for anyone now. Well, I work on the weekends for a club, but whatever. That's not really, doesn't really count. The job that I, like, one of the two jobs that I just left, I was there for about, I don't know, I feel like 3 years, bro. I don't even know how I did it. The only reason I stayed there that long is because they wouldn't let me leave. I tried to quit twice and they would not let me leave. They just kind of just like threw it out, I guess. My little termination thing, I feel like they just, not termination, my little like I quit letter, I think they just threw it out. They just kept putting me on the schedule, so whatever. But yeah, like I stayed there for 3 years and it killed me. I've never stayed at any job for more than like a year, year and a half without being like, okay, it's time for me to go. And what I realized is I'm never gonna find like a spot where I wanna be long term because I don't wanna work for anybody. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't wanna be here for 12, I don't wanna be here for 12 years. I don't wanna be here for 30 years. I hear people saying like, oh, I've been with this company for such and such years and blah, blah. And I'm like, wow, that's great. But like, I don't see that being my life. So like, all of that being taken into consideration, I was like, nah, like I need to figure it out. And I always knew that that was gonna be the end result. I always knew that I wanted to, you know, be an entrepreneur, but I think it was just, in me already. You know what I mean? And I feel like it's just one of those things that some people have it and some people don't. And if you don't, that's okay. Like, it's not a big deal. Like, if you're someone that likes to work for someone, that's fine. Like, that's, it is what it is. Like, I don't know. I think everyone is just on this, like, entrepreneurship wave. Like, oh, everyone needs to be, I need to be running. I need to be a boss. Like, you could be a boss. There's so many ways to be a boss. Like, doing, like, being let me break it down so that it will forever and always remain broke, okay? Like, being a real boss, like, the true definition of a boss to me is doing whatever you, like, being successful in your own terms. Like, being your, whatever you see successful as, that's you. If you're doing that, if you're doing whatever it is that you deem to be successful, whether that be you an entrepreneur or you're a doctor or you're a chef or I don't know, you work at Foot Locker and you're like, whatever it is that you deem to be successful, if you're doing that, you're winning and you're a boss. That's it. You don't have to be on nobody's yacht to be deemed a boss. You don't have to be raking in thousands of dollars a night to be deemed a boss. No, if you're doing whatever it is that you want to be doing for you and your family, you're a boss, you won, that's it. Question 4, where do I see myself in 5 years? I had a couple people ask, where do I see myself in 3 years? And then I've had a couple people ask where I see myself in 5, so I'm just gonna kind of divide them together. Add them together. I don't know. The only reason, and I say I don't know, if you would have asked me this question, if I would have been answering this question last year, my answer would have been completely different. If I would have been answering this question 2 years ago, my answer would have been completely different from that. So like, excuse me again. I don't really know. Like, I swear I just live my day. I live my life like day by day. And I know that sounds crazy, but like, there's no such thing as plans, you know? Like, how many plans did y'all have for March and April? And that canceled, you know what I mean? Like, we're sitting in the house until America decides that we can leave. So, like, there's no such thing as plans. There's no such thing as like making plans and, oh, like, I wanna do that. Like, of course there are places that I wanna be in 3 years, in 5 years. Of course there are things that I wanna see grow. Of course there's like a fantasy of where I'll be in 3 or 5 years, or there's a fantasy of where I'll be next week. But like, that's not how life works, you know? So I don't know. Hopefully though, to answer your question hypothetically, I don't know. I just want to be successful, man. I just want to be doing everything it is that I have, all the little plans that I have in my head. I just want to see those plans being played out. Just so I can look back like, yeah, like, I did that. Like, that's all I want. That's really all I want. You know, that's what this whole thing is about. Like, that's what I tell people all the time. Like, you need to really focus in and figure out what you want out of life. Like, what do you want out of this life? Like, what is it? Because like, if it's something that really doesn't matter, it's like, this whole life is being wasted. Like, for what? Like, this life is being wasted. Like, what are you doing for money? Stupid. Like, What are you doing it for? Like pop, to be popular? Stupid. What are you doing it for? To I don't know. Just like things that don't matter, you know? Like, but yeah, like I wanna be able to just see all my plans being played out and just to look back, like all the hard work, all the determination, all the sacrifice, worth it. And I did it. I think I just want bragging rights. I really just want to be like, you know what? I did that. Like, I don't know. Also, like once I start to see a little bit of success, I do want to just take a year or two off and just travel the world. I don't want to come back home in like for like 2 years. Like I want to leave one. I want to, and for of course, like for a little bit. So I want to be in a country for maybe, I don't know, 3 months, and then I want to go to another country for 4 months, and you know what I mean, like go to another country for, I don't know, maybe 2 weeks, and then go to, you know what I mean. So like I want to just travel the world for 2 straight years. Once I do start to see a little bit of, you know, momentum, and I can afford to take 2 years off, then I want to do that. That's why I really stopped, like I stopped traveling, because I which is bad. I know I should like utilize my time while I have it, but I don't plan on waiting that much longer. Like I plan on the ball to get rolling like very, very shortly. So I don't think it'll be that long that I'm sitting, not traveling. But yeah, that's where I hope to be in 5 years. But again, you never know, you know, life has other plans. Question number 5, like a list of celebs that I would want to meet. So I have like a list. I've come across some celebs. I've come across some people. And the thing is, I'm trying to figure out how I can say this. I don't really glorify anyone. Like, except Beyonce, like, but I glorify Beyonce not because she's Beyonce, but I glorify Beyonce because Beyonce is the hardest working woman in show business. Like, let's just be real. Like, that's just what it is. And I'm talking to all of you that deem Beyonce to be overrated. That woman doesn't sleep. Like, she, don't get me started. But anyway, I don't glorify any of them. And here's why. I think I said before, like, you only know the side of the story. You only know things about people that they tell you or that they're willing to show you. And who these stars or celebrities are to us, like who they put out, who they project on us, may not necessarily be who they really are. That's number one. Number two, I feel like that's been proved. Like, I feel like not all of them, but like some of the celebs that I've come across, I've been like, you're actually a weirdo. Like, or you're actually like pretty great. Like, you know what I mean? Or like, you're actually just not who I thought you would be. You know what I mean? So it's hard for me to put. And then they're also just people. Like, I feel like it's so wild to me because as I started to really buckle down and just focus on building myself as a brand and just building, you know, shaping my future, I feel like I started to look at people differently. And I mean, in general. So I don't, everybody, no matter status or race or age or whatever, I just started looking at people through like different eyes. And I feel like they're just people that did something with it. You know, like they're just regular people that chose to do something. Or they were regular people that were having fun or and got on. Or they were regular people that decided that they wanted this and did it. You know what I mean? Like, they're just regular people. They're not superheroes. They're not these, like, don't get me wrong, they're inspirations and they're great half the time. No, I don't know, but like, you know, things like that. So it's hard for me to like sit and really look at these people in like a crazy light. However, there are people that are celebrities that I would love to just sit and like talk to, pick their brain. Common, oh my God, Kanye West, Andre 3000, Frank Ocean, Tyler, the Creator. I fucking love Tyler, the Creator. Like, to just be able to sit, and there's so many more, Meryl Streep. People like that, like those are people that I would wanna like sit, Erykah Badu. I would love to just sit, ugh, rest in peace, Dick Gregory. I would love to talk to, like, those are people that I would love to sit and talk, even Beyonce. I would love to sit and talk to Beyonce. Like, not to just be like, I don't know if I could sit and talk to Beyonce for real, cause I would be like, girl, I don't think I could look Beyonce in her eyes. Like people all over the world know who Beyonce is. She is going, like, what did she say on that song? She said, last name gonna be here forever. Whew. Last name gonna be here forever. Do you understand what kind of goals? Do you understand the amount of like power? Do you understand the amount of flex in that statement? Besides Beyonce, I don't have anyone that I would just, that I just like am in awe of, but maybe in awe, but in a different kind of way. Like, oh my God, like, I wanna just talk to you. I wanna have a moment of your time just to hear some wise words from you. Kendrick Lamar, I would love to talk to Kendrick Lamar. I feel like Kendrick has seen some stuff. What? It's always those, I always like feel for like, you know, like those like, cause I feel like Kendrick is one of those younger kids, one of those kids that was super like weird, not weird, but like quiet, kept to himself. And here he is, like literally in the middle of the hood. I know he's seen some stuff. Diddy, loves to talk to Diddy. There's a list, like there's a bunch of people that I would just love to just like, Jay-Z, for sure, I would love to talk to Jay-Z. Bunch of people that I would love to just like sit and chat with. I would love to just be at a table and just talking. Not even talking, but just listening. I would love to just be around to hear those people talk in a private setting where they can be themselves and really, J. Cole, wow, I would love to talk to J. Cole. Well, J. Cole is probably number one. To be able to sit and like have lunch with J. Cole, wow. But that's it. Those are all the questions that I have. I hope this video wasn't terrible. Because I'm really, really high and I'm sorry. But yeah, that's all I have. The next Ask Angel video, I don't know when that will be, but keep looking out for it so you can ask me questions, ask me some advice. I know you guys don't know me yet. Like, you guys don't really know me like that to be asking me advice, and I understand that. So that's why I'm trying to, like, you know, I started with some, you know, opener questions, and so you guys can try to get to know me a little more. But yeah, ask me for advice, just a question that you want answered. I don't know, like anything. If you want to know anything else about me, anything, just ask me. Make sure to check out the description box again below. Follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter, check out my SoundCloud link in the description box as well, so you can keep up with new episodes of my podcast. I'm gonna be like grouping my podcasts and putting them on YouTube. So I did 1-5 already, so of course, you know, 6-10 will be on there shortly. Check out my websites that are also in my description box, and that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Sorry it's been so long. I hope you guys have a safe quarantine. I hope you guys are eating well. Read, stop watching the news, like meditate, eat some fruit, please drink some water, get some natural spring water, get some sleep, and that's it. Bye.